China, A History of China and East Asia, 3rd edition. Ancient China, Imperial Dynasties, Communism, Culture, Martial Arts, Medicine, Military, People including Mao Zedong, Confucius, and Sun Tzu. Written by Adam Brown. Narrated by Sarah Moore. Introduction. I want to thank you and congratulate you for purchasing the book China, A History of China and East Asia. This book contains everything you need to know about China's rich and exciting history. China has become the world's most populous nation with a powerful economy. As its landscape has changed over the years, so has its demographics and economy. It is known as one of the oldest recorded civilizations in history. With a vast landscape and a rich, diversified culture, the country is famous for martial arts, Confucius philosophy, language, alternative treatment like acupuncture and herbal treatments, the Great Wall of China, and a recorded history that dates to as early as over 3,000 years ago. Furthermore, China has a unique dynastic history with military development, medicinal breakthroughs, and great legendary figures, the likes of which the world has never seen. So how did it all come to be? How did the People's Republic of China become what it is today? This book reveals the building process that caused a small group of people to become part of a full-blown nation. It will provide you with the details you need to have a good understanding of how the country was shaped into what it is today. Thanks again for purchasing this book. I hope you enjoy it. Chapter 1. Ancient Chinese Dynasties. Overview of Dynasties. A dynasty in Chinese literature refers to a series of rulers from the same family and historical periods, named after the family that dominated the country at the time. Some dynasties lasted for many centuries, while others were in power for only a few years. The earliest dynasty began with the first ruler in 2200 BC. And ended in 1912 with the last emperor of China. From 1912 to 1949, the country that was previously Imperial China became the Republic of China. Thus, more than 4,000 years of dynasties came to an end when the last emperor was forced to leave his seat. From 1949 onwards, the country became known as the People's Republic of China, which continues today. 1. Xia Dynasty, 2200 to 1600 BC. Around 2200 BC, the occupants of what is now northern China near the Yellow River came under the rule of the Xia Dynasty. There is little evidence for this dynasty's existence apart from some records that were compiled much later by reliable historians. It is theorized that the people began to use bronze during this time, due to some evidence suggesting that bronze casting occurred at Erlitau during the Xia Dynasty. Legend states that it was Yu the Great, 2200 to 2100 BC, who began the dynasty. He was a hard worker among the early settlers who helped to ensure the safety of his people. It is documented that the Yellow River constantly flooded the land and caused great difficulty among the people. Crops would be ruined, homes would flood, and the people would complain about the hardship that they were in. Yu the Great is known for building dams that ultimately helped to stop flooding in his community, and he became well known for his nobility, leading to the people choosing him as their ruler. Thus, the very first dynasty was founded. The Xia Dynasty had 17 kings and continued until 1600 BC when the Shang Dynasty came into power. 2. Shang Dynasty, 1600 to 1046 BC. Ji of the Xia Dynasty had begun to oppress the people through taxation and unjust laws that were enacted only to benefit the nobility. The people who suffered the most were peasants, who worked long hours and earned meager wages, and occupied the lower strata of society. Because of the hardship suffered at the hands of the Xia rule at this time, a rebellion began. People threw their support behind Chen Tang, who convinced them they needed a new king. The revolt spread until Ji, the last Xia emperor, was overthrown by a final battle known as the Battle of Mingqiao. Most of Ji's army either deserted the plain of battle or surrendered to the stronger force of Chen Tang. Thus, around 1600 BC, the Shang dynasty came to power. Western scholars previously used to debate the existence of the Shang dynasty because much of the knowledge came only from ancient Chinese literature. However, during the 1920s, archaeological excavations unearthed considerable evidence for its existence. Scholars believe that the Shang dynasty achieved much more progress than the Xia dynasty, but this may be due to the minimal historical data about the Xia dynasty. Nonetheless, major cities and urban hubs, including Anyang and Zhengzhou, were established during the Shang dynasty. At its height, the Shang state only controlled a relatively small area of northern China, but their rule became a model for other rival states, including the Zhao state. Manufacturing of bronze is known to have continued during this time period. Brass was made from the abundant suppliers of copper, tin, and lead that were dug by the Chinese. The miners provided these metals to blacksmiths, who smelted them into bronze. Most bronze was used for ornaments or for ritual objects, while only a small amount was used for weaponry and agriculture. The Shang organized society in a form of feudalism, in which relatives of the king and other nobles were granted land in return for their service and loyalty. This resulted in the kings having a great deal of power, and like the kings before them, were more at risk of abusing that power. The last Shang king was accused of drunkenness, incest, cannibalism, sadism, and was considered evil. The virtues that had once led to the elevation of the Shang were decimated as a result. Once again, there was an uprising against the tyrant king. Sensing vulnerability, Wu Wang from the east attacked the Shang Empire and came to power after winning the Battle of Muye. The defeat of the last Shang king, who ironically had been named King Zhao at his own coronation, in 1046 BC, effectively began the Zhao dynasty. 3. The Zhao dynasty, 1046 to 256 BC. Wu Wang became the first king of the Zhao dynasty after the Shang fell from power. The dynasty lasted until 256 BC, making it the longest to rule for nearly 800 years. The kings had learned from their predecessors and did not make many of the same mistakes. Wu Wang is known to have established the concept of the Mandate of Heaven. The people believed that the king was appointed by the divine and only the appointed individual had the right to rule in China. The ancient Egyptian pharaohs had a similar concept in which it was believed the pharaoh was the closest to the gods and appointed by the divine. For Wu Wang, this served two purposes. First, this solidified his claim on the throne as legitimate and unquestionable. He was then not a conquering king, but a destined king. Secondly, the mandate quenched all possible dissent with the argument that as a king from the divine, he was the only person fit to rule. This made it more difficult to question the king's ability as ruler, which had led to the previous dynasty's demise. After all, Wang had been sent as the solution to the Shang Emperor, who was disgraced by his lack of virtue. The Zhao dynasty was the third and last of the three pre-imperial dynasties. In the course of the Zhao dynasty, there were 39 kings who followed one another mostly through father-to-son succession. Initially, the Zhao dynasty began well by building a successful defense of the country against the barbarians in the west. However, as the centuries passed, the country became disunited and there was a great deal of internal strife. Despite this, there were major advancements in the organization of society, technology, construction, trade, and agriculture. Some very important features of Chinese thought and philosophy also came to the forefront during this time, the most notable of which are Confucianism and Tao religion. In the three pre-imperial dynasties, the ruler was viewed as a king who was both a leader and a warrior. Because he was an intermediary to the divine who resided in heaven, The king would perform rituals with the help of his...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.